Some of us are wondering what's going to happen with this problem with ISIS and ISIL and all these people. They are going to encounter eventually the mercy of God. They may have some military conflict with Israel in the meantime, but there is going to be an opportunity even for them to turn to Christ should they wake up and realize where they are. That's powerful. So Jonah's up on the hill, and a plant grows up, and it gives him shade. Have you ever read Jonah 4? And so he's all excited about this, but then God kills the plant. And then Jonah's mad at God again. He's mad at God because he is not comfortable. His reason for not going on time the first time to deliver the message was he was uncomfortable. He was trying to edit God's message instead of being God's delivery boy. He thought he was bigger than what God made him to be. Come on, somebody. Some of us are aspiring toward ministry, but we will have no real ministry unless we understand that what we are called to do boils down to simply taking your position and moving into your role and faithfully carrying out your unique assignment. I tell you, like some of the kids say right now, one of our problems is we're trying to do too much. And God says, I don't need all that much. So when God cuts down the tree, then Jonah had to understand that what he was trying to do was he was more concerned about a plant and his own comfort than he was with 120,000 souls and a city that spanned about 60 miles in circumference, and he didn't have a kingdom perspective. Are we in the belly of the whale? Are we in a place where we need the grace of God to kick in? Do we need to turn around and go back to an assignment? Some of us are like Jonah in that our assignment that we're missing out to the outside world is not obvious. His assignment, his missing it, his sin was a sin of omission, a lack of obedience, a sense of unbelief. Next week, next month, we're going to begin to talk a little bit about something, and I haven't gotten a title for it yet, but it's based on a book that came out about 15 years ago called Experiencing God. How many have ever read the book Experiencing God? A handful of us. How many have never even heard of the book Experiencing God? You never heard of it. Experiencing God, subtitle is Knowing and Doing the Will of God. And the book is really only about what to do at moments when God breaks into your world and begin to do like he did with Jonah, make a demand upon you to move into his will. Any command, directive that God gives carries with it an assigned dimension of grace. And what we refuse to do keeps us out of the grace that God has ordained. Grace and favor are tied together. Favor is a manifestation of grace. Favor is when God, allows you to be received by someone who needs the message that he is sending. Grace is the empowerment of God. Grace is the ability of God coming upon you. Some of us are in circumstances right now where it looks like what we believe God wants us to do in this next move, in our careers, in our community, what God wants us to do seems to be unthinkable, unreachable, untenable, seems to be too big for us. God is about, I believe, to promote, to bless, to enter certain arenas of our world and our lives through ordinary people being positioned in extraordinary with extraordinary opportunities in places of his choosing. God wants a new set of people at the Pentagon, in the Supreme Court, in our various educational institutions. Come on, somebody. And he's only got us to work with, and those who cling to worthless idols forfeit the grace, forfeit the blessing that could be theirs. Those who cling to worthless vanities, vain ideas, they don't get in line with what God is doing. And so I believe that we're on the verge as a people. I'm talking about Christians in America. And we're on the verge as Christians in this area. We're on the verge as Hope Christian Church, many of us as individuals. We're on the verge of entering into some things that God has ordained, but we need to be acting on a God idea, not your best understanding. Some of us spend too much time trying to figure out what to do rather than getting the big idea from God.